You probably know my next guest as a rich business tycoon and a reality TV star. No, he's not Donald Trump. He is Kevin O'Leary from Shark Tank, and he just made a big announcement. Listen.
I'm an international business investor. I've traveled everywhere around the world. I'm a proud Canadian citizen. I brought with me this, my Canadian passport. Nowhere in this document does it say that I have to settle, or in our Constitution, for mediocrity, for incompetence, and in some cases, stupidity. Let's change all that. We need a leader that can actually deal with Trump. We need a leader in the Conservative Party that can beat Trudeau, and that means I have to expand the base of the Conservative Party.
So joining me now is Kevin O'Leary. Kevin, thank you for joining us.
Great to be here. Thank you.
Oh, so after much speculation last week, you formally announced your candidacy for the Conservative leader in Canada. You are known as a celebrity businessman, a reality TV star. You're on the hit show Shark Tank that we watch. You have little political experience. Are you the Trump of Canada?
Business. Mm-hmm. There's been that analogy, but I tell you why it's not a good. I mean, obviously Trump and I have got some notoriety on reality television, but here's where the you know, this all is different. I'm actually an immigrant. I'm half Lebanese, half Irish. If Canada was building walls, I wouldn't exist. Canada's a very inclusive country. It's a unique society. It's got two languages, Francais, Anglais. It's French and English. It's different than the United States. But we're the largest trading partner of the U.S. We've had a relationship with the U.S. for over 100 years. 38 states represent the largest trading partner that they have is Canada. And so we have a really interesting dynamic together. We share the largest border. Mm-hmm. We've been friends forever in every way, militarily, from society. But at the same time, everything changed. What happened in Canada, which happened in a lot of other countries, is everybody got Trump wrong. And so up in Canada, the current prime minister has been raising taxes, adding regulations, adding a national carbon tax to a country that's all natural resources, which was a huge shock to everybody, and promising to plunge the country into $1.5 billion of debt, which was the final straw for me.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, Trump gets elected, and he is way out of sync with our number one trading partner. And Canadians are very concerned now, and I'm one of them.
You're talking about Justin Trudeau, the current prime minister. Since you mentioned trading, let's talk about NAFTA. Donald Trump has said he's going to dismantle NAFTA. You saw what he did with TPP today. He withdrew. Are you concerned about the impact that that would have on your country? What should he do as it concerns Canada?
Very concerned. I listened to all the data coming out of the White House today because I'm obviously an investor globally, and NAFTA is a big deal for me. What I heard the president say through his press secretary was, I'm willing to negotiate within the confines of the agreement with Canada and Mexico, but if I don't like that outcome, I'm tearing that agreement up too. So he's looking at leverage. But you know, our country should be working together. Let me give you an example. Energy independence. As you know, Canada is one of the richest countries on earth in natural resources. That XL pipeline that we tried to build with Obama cost shareholders up in Canada $3.2 billion of failed initiatives for 8 years. Basically, we got screwed around. I'm not happy about that. But I'd be happy to sit down with Trump and renegotiate because I know he wants ownership and royalties. But that pipeline should allow the energy that's going to flow through it, which gives security to every American, and we're in partners on this thing. We don't want to pay taxes on that. That should be a tax-free pipeline because it's a national interest to supply North America with energy. That's the kind of deal I'm worried about now that NAFTA is getting organized this way.
Mm-hmm.
Softwood lumber, another big deal for us. Military procurement, we spend billions of dollars buying weaponry because we're in partnership militarily. We need to keep our relationship open, and we're good for 9 million American jobs in 38 states.
Is this why you said that we meaning Canada, need a leader who can actually deal with Trump?
I think globally, not just in the U.S. or Canada, but look at Britain and even Colombia and South America, the body politic has decided that they would like people that have some executional experience, executional excellence, as it were, business leaders that make goals, set goals, get things done. And that's what you do in business. That's how you define success. And all of a sudden, the traditional politician is not the favorite outcome in many situations. And I think that's going to happen in Canada, too.
Yeah.
I can't believe my country of Canada, with the boundless resources it has to plunge itself into $1.5 trillion of debt. I've got two kids, one's 20, one's 23. there's not a chance in hell I'm going to let Justin Trudeau do that. That's not going to happen. And there's millions of Canadians that are looking at me saying, yeah, we can't let that happen.
Yeah, but he's very popular in Canada. I mean, you think you can beat him in 2019?
You know, there's such an amazing thing when you fall in love, particularly in politics. The first year is euphoria. Then reality strike. I don't know if you've been watching lately. Probably not. But the Canadian polls for Justin Trudeau are falling like a rock because all of a sudden, many people are starting to realize that he's not getting stuff done that he promised. He promised a $10 billion deficit and he would clear it up in 2019. We're now over $38 billion. We're getting nervous. We're not happy with the performance metrics. And that's what's the same thing that happened stateside. All of a sudden, Americans said, I want somebody in here for all the flaws he's got that can get stuff done. Yeah. And wow, in this 24-hour cycle, you have to admit, Trump has really got into as an agenda. I've never seen this kind of speed.
Yeah. What did you think about, he's had a rocky start in his first full day, but you said he's gotten into an agenda and he's done a lot. Quickly, what do you think, how's he doing?
I think you have to leave the whole style thing alone and just measure the performance. I mean, Trump is an unusual candidate, there's no question about it. I, like everybody else, was amazed at what happened. But I think you've got to give him his 100 days and see what happens. And I think he's going to perform well, which makes me nervous for Canada, because we need to sit down. I understand we're going to start negotiating with him next week.
But that performing well, that's good for the U.S. But listen, if you do win, or when you run, I mean, during the 2019, come back to us, and if you win, make us your first stop. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. We come right back. Millions of people around the world marched against President Trump this weekend. But is it a moment or a movement? And what will they do next?
The Statue of Liberty, that beacon of freedom, giving the Nazi salute? It's an ad for the second season of The Man in the High Castle, the show available on Amazon Prime about what could have happened if the Nazis had won World War II. Check out this scene from the show. The famous video of Marilyn Monroe singing Happy Birthday with a shocking twist.
Happy birthday.
The billboard is getting a big reaction today.
That's just pretty offensive, I think.
I can see people get offended.
Yeah, I think it's pretty terrible. I don't know why they would do that.
In a statement, Amazon says, if you're interested to see what an alternate world could look like if history had gone another way, you should watch the show. And this was the chaotic scene last night at Texas A&M University. Riot police faced off in a hallway with demonstrators furious at the appearance of white nationalist leader Richard Spencer. There were raucous scenes inside the hall, too.
Trump.
Spencer sparked an uproar last month at a meeting in Washington with several supporters giving the Nazi salute. Now, more controversy.